tranquil and relaxing and feels so nice. And then Maya can have her restorative in the bedroom.
Excellent.
Okay. Okay, you guys, so let yourself relax. Everyone can close their eyes. Just whatever position you feel most comfortable in. You can cover the eyes if you want. And just giving yourself a chance to really rest fully. Can you hear me from there, Alan?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Perfect. So arms can come into any position, either overhead or on the belly or alongside. And then just beginning to come into your breath and letting yourself settle in. Thank you.
Are you doing a class?
It's already started, Michelle. Someone else is already in a position.
Oh, I wrote an email to you, never heard back.
I'd rather not speak about it while the class, he's already there, but we might not do a full one because I'm in Portland right now with my friends.
All right.
Yeah, that's why I didn't get an email from you. I checked before, I didn't see it. Did you email me on Facebook? I can't hear you now.
Class, and next, let me know the next time.
Why don't you just join us? He's in Shavasana already, and I'm playing an instrument, so I don't want to keep talking while.
All right.
So if you want it, why don't you?
All right. I don't see anything here.
Oops, I muted myself. Sorry.
You muted and you also, there's no visual. All there is.
I know, that was not intentional. Somehow it turned off, the video turned off on its own. Alan, keep resting. No, your Wi-Fi is not turned off, sweetie. I just turned my video off on the computer accidentally. Michelle, we're just in Stonehenge Shavasana or whatever Shavasana you want. This is like our meeting last week, you guys. It's all the same of us. So I'm happy you're both here and you're doing restorative. Is that happy hands, Alan? That was happy. So my students tonight are Maya, Raven Sky in the bedroom, Alan and Michelle. Michelle, I need to just text you. And you should just text. You should text me too. It's all good. Don't get frustrated. You're here now.
I'm not in this room. If you want to send a text to me, I have to go in the other room.
All right. No, you don't need. I'm not sending a text to you now.
Oh, okay.
I'm talking about for the class. Okay, I'm gonna mute all the videos.
Sorry.
No, you're good. Don't worry. Okay, guys, I just muted in case somebody else comes on, but if you have a question, just write me a little chat or Michelle, just wave at me and I'll come back and turn on the sound. I'm going to play the instrument. So whatever Shavasana that you want, you can take. We're doing Stonehenge though, but you can, you know, set it up for your liking. Thank you.
just continue staying in your Shavasana. And I'm just going to put the drum aside for a moment. And you can just remain there for the next several minutes. Just even letting yourself embrace the quiet and the silence if you don't have music playing. Embracing that just normal outside sounds of living that are happening. Okay, guys, and starting to wiggle your fingers and your toes. You can stretch out. And then rolling to one side to come back up. Let's see, sorry, my thing got adjusted here. Hopefully you can see my mat. Why does it keep freezing my screen? Sorry, guys. I don't know why it keeps doing that. There we go. Okay. So you're going to take, set up your, can you guys see my bolster? I'm sorry. I'm doing it on my phone, so it's a little hard to tell what you can see and can't see. So you will set up for the twisted, for the twisted side lying warrior. You know, where we do that one where you're here and you take the legs back and you're going to turn your belly and chest over the bolster. So I'm using sort of like a smaller version of a bolster right now. And then you just turn the belly and chest over and then lie down. And you can use your bolster or whatever variation. I'm just doing a whole bunch of blankets. And then just letting yourself come into the twist, but to rest to the side. Perfect. And again, if you can, just give your way yourself to the silence and the quiet.
Okay, you guys, you can begin to bring yourself back up and rotate to the other side. And then just letting yourself relax into it. Feel free to cover the eyes if you'd like, or follow the breath if you feel distracted in the mind and just coming out of that thinking mind and more into the body. How is your body feeling? What is it saying to you? Can you create space for that and also to give it some healing, loving, compassionate energy? And just feeding each breath slowly in and slowly out. And then again, wiggling your fingers and toes, you guys can begin to make your way back. And then setting up and just reversing your body for a Supta Baddha Konasana. So you'll bring your hips. I'm gonna use a pillow for my knees just for tonight. And I'll just go back against the bolster. And then I'm gonna bring this, you can even do this on top of a bolster. It's great. You go soles of the feet together, knees wide apart, and then you rest back. Palms up, or hands can come onto the belly.
Okay, you guys, you can wiggle your fingers and your toes and begin to stretch out again. And roll into your right or left-hand side. How you guys doing? Are you sweating there? I'm sweating. I'm so hot. It's hot in Portland. I'm in Portland. Okay, so now we're going to do a child's pose. As long as your knees feel okay, you can come. Yeah, you don't have to do it on your knees. Michelle, if you wanted to, what about this? Does this bother your back, Michelle, to go this way? This way? You could do that way, like a forward fold or a cross. Just anything that's like a forward fold. You can even prop yourself up on a chair and fold this way over something if you can't do a child's pose. Yeah, sometimes I even just put blankets under my belly and I fold this way. So it's really just to get a forward fold. Whatever forward fold you want to do, you can do. You can do even Baddha Konasana and fold forward. Your choice, yeah, whatever forward fold for like a few minutes. Your head can go in either direction, whatever feels comfortable. Yeah, there you go, Michelle. Perfect. That's good. Turn your head the other way if you'd like at this point. I'm just rotating so the neck is comfortable from side to side. Thank you. okay, and then slowly beginning to rise back up, and you can stretch the legs either out. Like for you, Michelle, you can stretch the legs out just to get movement, and then Alan and I, we can stretch the legs back. So you're just going to create a little bit of movement. Okay, and then next position will be the side lying shavasana. So this one, oh wait, I'm sorry, I wanted to do a back bend before that. So for the back bend, this one's called Babbling Brook. So you create a couple of rolls. So if you don't have a lot of blankets, you can just use your bolster and maybe one blanket. So I'm going to use this one, where I'm going to place one blanket roll under my knees, like a long blanket, skinny blanket roll under my knees. One. Then I'm going to do one for my back, my mid back, and then one for my neck. So you don't have to, since like Alan, if you have just one bolster, you'll just put something under your head and you can lay over the bolster, not long ways on your mat, but you're going to go the other way. So turn it. Yeah. And then your back, your shoulder. Yeah, exactly. How can I fold this? This is unusual. The size of this. That's not going to work. Let's try it this way. Aha. I got it. Okay, so then one for the legs, one for the back, maybe something for the head if you want. Michelle's already there. You beat me to it, Michelle. She's quick. Okay, you guys, let yourself rest, whatever the position may be. Oh, yeah. And then the arms can either come to a T. Usually I find that's the most comfortable for my back, is to go wide, but that's up to you. If you want to go more like Shavasana arms, you can. Mm-hmm. That looks great.
Okay, you guys, and then you can bend your knees and begin to roll to your right-hand side. And then you want to have your bolster, one bolster, and you need a blanket for your head, something to cushion your head because you're going to lie on your side. So you don't want your head to be cockeyed. So usually I take like a blanket folded like this, or just I'll find out once I lie down. Usually I need about that medium size height, then a bolster. And I have just like a little makeshift bolster I'm going to make here. I'll show you. Usually I use blankets if I don't have a bolster, and I just roll them up together. So if you never have one, or if you don't have one in the moment, this is a good way to do it. You just take them, take two blankets, and voila, you got a bolster. Hey, look at that. So then you lie down, one leg comes out straight, the bottom leg is straight, top leg comes on the bolster, and the bolster comes close to you like this, like when you're sleeping at night. This bottom arm though, this one that you're lying on, you want to pull it out so the shoulder blade kind of comes flush against the ground. If you have an extra bolster or pillow, this is a nice trick. You put it up against your back like that, and then you're real cozy. So this is a decently long one on each side, so just make sure you're really comfortable. You can cover your eyes to let the light, to block out the light. just at your own pace, you can roll over to the other side. And just taking your time, no rush.
My left hip hurts. I can't be doing that. I can't hear you either. It's okay.
Do you want to do another pose? Maybe another pose, like another Shavasana, because we're almost at the end. So for the next 7 minutes, or meditation.
Let's do meditation.
Okay, because I'm gonna we're gonna come out in a second. I'm just gonna mute it for a moment.
All right.
Okay, you can begin to stretch and to move. And then making your way up to a seat for meditation. Michelle, are you on your phone? What are you doing?
You're in yoga class.
Are you on your telephone? No. What's the problem? Okay. Well, all right. You can take a comfortable seat. Let's finish together. So feel free to let your eyes close just for a moment or two more. And just trying to let yourself stay centered and grounded in your breath and the intention behind your practice. And what it is that you really need to be, in a way of positivity, feeding to yourself at this moment now. I'm just sending a little prayer out to all beings, that all beings may be safe and free from harm, and that may all beings be happy and healthy. May all beings be loved and supported, and may all beings feel loving kindness. If you guys like to join me for one om, actually let's do three oms. If you want to join me for three oms, you can take three oms. If not, you can just listen. Your choice. I have you off of mute so I can hear you too. So if you want a chance, so don't be shy. It's just us. Okay, you guys, take a deep breath.
Out there, including you, Michelle. Happy Mother's Day. Namaste.
Mother's Day.
Happy Mother's Day. To all the little mothers. Okay, you guys. Hope that you have a good night.
Thank you, Chrissy.
You're welcome. I have to get to making dinner for Maya and I here, so I'm going to hop off quick tonight.
Sending love to you and Maya.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
All right, we'll see you soon.
Sending love right back at you. See you soon.
Bye.
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 Love you, Michelle. Happy Mother's Day. Did you have a good one?
No.
Why?
It's okay.
I need to give you a hug. You need a hug.
That's part of the problem.
I know. You need a hug. I'm giving you a hug.
Thank you.
Oh, I'm hugging you super tight.
I ended up talking to my son, but it was mainly him talking to me about his breakup with his girlfriend.
Oh. Well, okay. Well,
that's what Mother's Days are like when you're a mom.
When you're a mom, it's true. Okay. Well, okay. I'm sending you love and the biggest hug ever. And I'm so glad that you came. I didn't announce it because I'm in Portland caretaking Maya right now. And I just wasn't sure if anyone would come.
All right. So,
and then I realized, I was like, I wonder if Michelle will come. And I said it to Alan. And he's like, yeah, well, maybe. And I was like, yeah. I was like, Michelle's from, because he used to live in Palo Alto.
All right.
To my classes at Avalon. And you guys, none of the people that are from the Los Angeles studio are even taking this class. And this is through the studio. It's funny. I mean, people have, but you guys are my consistent. So I feel really grateful.
Well, you need to send things out. But I also know that you're busy taking care of your friends. So.
Yeah, no. I've been announcing it every week, except for this week. So I announce it every week, but I just didn't this week. So
somehow you don't have me on your list.
Oh, I don't know. I did email you last week. Did you get it?
I got that one. That's okay. Why I was able to log in today.
Yes.
Oh. I snoozed it for this week, and then I didn't hear from you. And
yeah. Well, that's why I was saying you can always text me too, and I can always text you just to give you.
I don't know if I even have your.
Here, let me give it to you in case we don't.
I don't know that I have your email. I mean your phone number.
I do, but it's been a long time. I used to have your. I have
this is Graham, 908-461-2782.
Ding ding ding! You got it.
All right.
All right, shoot me a text. Yep.
All right.
Okay, love you.
Love you too. Have a nice evening. Okay, I know night. Mother's Day is hard for you because you're your mama, but.
Yeah, I cried a lot today.
And my mama, I talked to her on Thursday, sort of.
Yeah.
I mean, she's so demented, it's not really a conversation.
No, she doesn't know. It's a hard thing. It's just hard.
Really hard. It's hard to know. What?
Hard for a lot of people.
I know.
Anyhow, let's love each other. Yeah.
Yes.
Love you, Mama. Love you.
Mwah. That's what my grandson does. Mwah.
He's so
okay. Bye bye.
Bye bye, sweetie.
You too.
Thank you.